What's up, you guys? I hope you guys are blessed today just as much as I am. Today has been a blessing. Yesterday has been a blessing. The day before yesterday has been a blessing. Now, I just want to say I love you guys. Every single one of you guys watching, those that are on my friends list and those that are not on my friends list, I love you guys, bro. Real talk. So, keyword is love. I have been feeling spirit-led to leave certain videos and just allowing the Lord through the Holy Spirit to speak to me. 100% praise and glory be to God, the one who gives me strength, my shelter, my refuge, the one who fights the wars for me and claims vengeance, the one who rescued me from my sin. Now, oh, there it goes, rescue me from my sin. It's true, from all my iniquity. And it was all placed on my man Jesus. So all I want to say is that I'm not the only one. I'm not the only one. And yup, I was driving with my kneecap. Anyways, I'm not the only one. I'm not the only one that has that opportunity to be able to just unleash fire. Fire through the glory of God. He gives us that power and authority, not just to trample over serpents and snakes, but also to bless others, to be able to labor for others in His image, to be able to represent as ambassadors of Christ so that people may see where this comes from. Because let me tell you straight up, it doesn't come from me. It comes from this guy right here. Jesus, Jesus, straight up. Now, love is the key word. I know a lot of us have been fighting some battles and it seems like we're never gonna win. I mean, this social media, this is an outlet to allow God to use me to speak to others. If not, I'll delete it. Honestly, whoever has my number, you can text or you can call me. That's how we work, right? As you guys already know that because I just came back like, what, a month ago to Facebook? And this time it's being used right. Now, love. Everything you do, do with love. I mean, John 15:12 says, my commandment is this, to love one another, right? To love one another as I loved you. Am I right or am I wrong? Okay, so love is a key word. Well, Brother Paul, like, this homie keeps talking smack. He keeps being dirty and trashy. Like, how am I supposed to win that with love? I just got to set him straight. No, you don't. You just love on him. How don't you know that that homie's not going through something? How don't you know that he went through a divorce? How don't you know that he's under depression? How don't you know that he is being attacked spiritually? How don't you know that he's being convicted and is having trouble accepting it? How don't you know that he is a human being and is just going through a really rough time and doesn't know how to fix it, doesn't know how to do it? And Jesus might be the outlet, but they don't know how to wield it, right? How to plug in the plug themselves into Jesus. How don't you know that if you don't go, hey, bro, calm down. What's wrong? Look, I love you, man. I'm here for you, and I want you to know that everything's going to be all right. Call on me, dude. Talk to me. Well, like, and you know what? All is forgiven. God says to forgive others if I've forgiven you. If not, what's going to happen when you go to heaven? What happens when you deny God? Because as you guys know, I ain't ashamed of the gospel. I ain't ashamed of Jesus Christ that lives in me, right? Galatians 2:20, I believe. For it is not I that lives, but Christ who lives in me. So how don't you know that someone is going through a rough time and you lashing out, being all crazy, doesn't just destroy your testimony. It also shows them that you can drop to their level being as strong as you are. Keyword is love. I mean, Corinthians, 1 Corinthians, I believe, right? 16:14 says, do everything in love. Everything you do in love. Whether you correct a brother, which the word says we must, or else he will answer for that. Whether it says that we must give your seat up because you see a lady. You know what? Even if it's not a lady, you see another homie, right? Whether he's thuggish, whether he is all nice and prepped out, whatever. Do everything out of love. 1 Peter 4:8. Above all, love each other deeply because love covers a multitude of sins. Ephesians 5:21, submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Keyword, submit to one another. Now, God came and was hit with the cat of nine tails, right? Whip. At the end of each whip, there were claws, nasty claws. And they would grip onto you and just rip you to shreds, your meat, your nerves, your skin. It will scratch your bones, right? I mean, it was disgusting. The word says that he did not even look like a man. He didn't look human, right? For who? For this guy and that guy? Just so it can be like, oh, all right, thank you, Lord, for doing that. You can go back. You can take your Holy Spirit. I'm going to be sin free. No, because God knows that we're going to fail, that we fall short of his glory. You know what's so beautiful to me, though, that even though my righteousness that I strive to give to him, it's like filthy rags, the word says. Filthy rags, right? But he is glorified with it, though, because he knows it's impossible for us to be sin free. He's the only one that came down to earth 100% human, gave his life. He gave his life. He wasn't killed. He didn't die. He gave his life. That's what he said. It is finished. Right? Or whatever. That's how I imagine. Right? And blowed out, you know, the last breath, went to hell, took those keys. Now the enemy can't go into heaven. He can't plead with God. It's over. Our salvation is through Jesus Christ alone. No sacrifices needed. No works needed. Now I have eternal life. As long as I'm humble, obedient, and strong in the word. Now the Lord knows our weaknesses. But he is delighted in our weakness, for he is strong, right? Come on, man. But sometimes it's hard to fight with love. Let me tell you, in all the years that I've grown with God and I've known God, I've known one thing. It hurts and it sucks to have to realize that you can't lash back. You can't go back and smack someone that smacked you. Right? Now, love. Our job here for the Great Commission is to go and win souls. To go and preach to all the nations. Not to be stuck behind four little walls and retire there and feel like you accomplished everything. And go to heaven. Yeah, you can go to heaven. I'm not saying that if you don't do that, you won't. But your crown, man, it's not going to be all pimped out. And the crown's not for you, because the word of God says that every good deed we do, every soul we win, whatever, right? It's like a jewel added, a beautiful jewel added to our crown, because we're going to be crowned when we get up to heaven. But the word says that it'll be laid down at his feet. I can't even imagine, bro. I want my crown to have so many diamonds, rubies, everything on there. Not for me. So when I present it to him as an offering, I mean, he can be like, Paul, I'm proud of you, my son. Daddy, I didn't do it because of me, okay? It was all because of you, for your glory. I don't care if I lose friends on Facebook. I don't care if I lose friends out here in the open, right? Which I consider the same. I don't care if I lose my house. I don't care what I lose and what leaves or what comes. It's all for you, Father God. Good job, my faithful servant. That's all I want to hear. In the midst of that, he loves me through it. So I think it's beautiful how love covers a multitude of sin, right? So fight with love. Don't drop down to the same level. That's pathetic. I've seen people, the greats, as I heard people call them, right? Hit rock bottom hard, displaying no love. Displaying no proof of his glory. I mean, James 1:19 says, know this, my beloved brothers, let every person be quick to hear, slow to speak, and slow to anger. For the anger of man does not produce the righteousness of God. True colors fly, guys. So when you're being tested, when you're going through persecution, tribulation, or conviction, remember that. Remember that. Because the righteousness of God will be displayed or not. But yet, God forgives us because we're all human. I love you guys, man. I love you guys. And regardless what, You guys are my brothers and sisters. Regardless what, I will spit my own blood and lay my life for you. And I had to talk with my family straight up, with my wife. That hit home for my wife. But she understands. And now that my beautiful, gorgeous, amazing, sexy little baby knows the Lord that much, she's getting in that same boat. And I'm so honored to call her my baby. I'm so honored to call her the mother of my children. I'm so honored to call her my wife, the fellow soldier I'm fighting with, right? Dressed with the armor of God. Because there's a roaring lion, man, seeking to devour and destroy and kill and steal everything. It's in the churches. It's in the streets. It's at work. It's in Food City, right? It's in Safeway. It's everywhere. Everywhere. Who's going to stand up and be the light? Allow God to shine through you. Who's going to stand up and fight? Who's going to stay humble? Now, when you feel like you're being overwhelmed, call on a brother, okay? When you feel like you're being overwhelmed, pray. My homie told me, hey, recently, I want you to pray the armor of God over yourself. Say, I will put on the breastplate of righteousness, the helmet of salvation, right? The belt of truth, the sword of the spirit, the sandals of readiness. Believe me, that's the best affirmation. It's better than, I am beautiful, I am strong. I get it, you are. But pray biblical affirmations. Watch. Proclaim it and declare it in the name of Jesus. Man, I have so much fire inside of me that it's not even funny. And I can't even start this fire myself. It's the God that's living in me, the Holy Spirit that's lighting me up. Because we are end day soldiers, baby. We are people that need to stand up for truth for my kids. What? Rather social media lead my kids? Rather false prophets lead my kids? Rather false dictators lead my kids? Rather schools that are teaching whatever they're teaching that's not okay lead my kids? Rather what? What are leading your kids? I'm not just, dude, our TV in the living room is for decorations. I took the plug in the back, and my kids and I are so united. We are so firm. We do everything together. Glory be to God. Like my old days, remember? When we barely had color TVs and there were no video games. The streets were filled with children and the parents were out there with them. What's up with that? Yeah, I get home from work tired too. Yeah, I'm going to nursing school. I get tired of that too. Well, about to start. Been off that semester. I get tired of a lot of things. But that's not an excuse to allow me to just kick back, chill, and let everyone else do the work. Love. You love your kids? Okay then. Raise them in the ways of the Lord. But Paul, what if it's not true? I had someone ask me that, right? All right. Now, I'm going to drop down to this level, right? Let's say it's not true, which is not, bro. People don't come back from the dead. Dude, you don't even know. I've seen cancer disappear from people. Fourth, actually, after the amazing church service, after we came from yesterday. All in the name of Jesus, right? I have homies who witnessed it. I witnessed it. A kid who was dead, no pulse, not breathing, come back up to life. Bones broken, healed. It's true. But let's say, though, that it's not. Did I have a bad life? Was I bound to addiction? No. The Word of God says be sober-minded. That I curse out, act like a fool, and destroy someone's heart, the way they think about something like church, when I'm bashing on them, oh, you go to church. Like, no, not like that, bro. No. Right? Because we all have a choice. We all have our private relationships. Was I drunk? No. Did I disrespect my woman, throughout my whole life and everything, all of that? No. Did my kids learn bad habits by watching me smoke and drink? No. Was I selfish and greedy? No. So all in all, was it a good life? Bro, It helped me be the best man I can be. It put a smile in the face in the middle of my depression when my brother passed. The day my son was born, December 26, 2020. It helped me feel alive again. Those of you that have known me, and those of you that know me 6 months ago, know, saw how destroyed and defeated I was due to everything that's going on. But let me tell you something. God has set me free. He is my chain breaker. He is my warrior. He fights for me. The battle's already won, bro. It's already won. Bring it. Right? That's how we got to think. That's how we have to be with our mentality in Christ. Now that I'm coming to a red light, let me read this part. Psalms 144, 1, 2. Pray this and shout it out when you feel attacked. Blessed be the Lord, my rock, who trains my hands for war and my fingers for battle, my loving kindness and my fortress, my high tower and my deliverer, my shield and the one in whom I take refuge, who subdues my people under me. Pray it, declare it, and fight. Don't put your head down like a little puppy. Don't lash back like a fool and just be acting all crazy. Right? Don't misrepresent God, because a testimony can, boom, be shattered just like that. Especially if you've been out there trying to win souls. If you've been in front of many declaring the name of Jesus. I have seen it. Believe me, I can declare it. And I can prove it. But you need to understand, God is a God who loves all. That's why he is there. Now, this was God led. And I don't know about you, but I'm obedient. I'd rather lose everybody and have the whole world hate me than to not speak the truth. And those of you that know me know what's up already. Those of you that know me know where I come from and that I'm not lying. Those of you that know me know that Christ lives in me. Bro, I've been called the wannabe. I've been called the fake. I've been called poisonous. I've been called weak. But God is my strength, my witness, my shield, and my sword. Those of you that know God know what's up, because you see it too, because you hear it too, and because you live it too. And that is God. Test the waters, people, but fight with love. Love one another as Christ has loved you. Straight up. I love you guys. You guys are more than enough. You guys are strong, because Christ is your strength. You guys are worthy, because Christ has redeemed you. You guys are blessed, because Christ has provided a way out. Love. Much love, bro. Much love. And much love, bras. Right, to all the girls. I'm trying to make up a word for women. Like, bro, what about bra? No, bra still like... Alright, no, nonsense. Alright, hit me up if you get a keyword for that. But also hit me up if you have questions. Discipleship is so important. And I am willing to speak to you. I'm willing to study with you. I'm willing to cry with you. I'm willing to go to your homie's house that lives in the hood, because you're afraid of getting shot up or stabbed up, to go fight for his soul. Believe me, God has been preparing my hands for war. So these hands are going to hit hard. And they're going to feel it. Because God is the strength behind it. God bless you. Gangsters for Jesus. Those of you that keep seeing that, this is a shirt from them. I'm part of Gangsters for Jesus. It's a little Christian group, crew. My general, Isaiah, and Evelyn. You can find them on Facebook. You can also find them on Gangsters for Jesus. They're a strong, discipling, evangelistical group that go around. It's just a couple that go around spitting fire everywhere, addressing, like Paul in the seven letters, right? Addressing things that need to be addressed in the church, speaking life, not just exhortation and correction, speaking through the power of God and filled with God. Hit them up. Listen to their preachings, man. And no, we ain't no cult. And no, we ain't no gang. Right? We're not gangsters for Jesus. We're a bunch of past OGs that have been saved by the grace of God. Right? Gangsters for Jesus. We don't throw up a set. We don't throw up all gangsters for Jesus. No, we don't do that. We are a group who spit fire given through the Holy Spirit inside of us. Represent, guys, because this hood, and I'm talking about planet Earth, belongs to Jesus. So who are you going to represent? Represent Jesus. Get in the Word and fight so He can bless your family, your life, and your everything around you, like He has with me. For I am a man of God. I'm a servant of the Most High. Straight up. Straight up. Love you.